that's my way across.
Yeah, it is. Let's go. Looks like we
don't think, Aloy. Just do it.
Don't think it, just do it. Better myself. Holy. Right, okay.
It's held like this for 19 years, right?
Well.
Don't answer.
19 years. Yeah, and here we are. 19 years later. Hoping to God it holds together.
Oh, glad that's over. Not this way. Maybe further up the shaft.
Understood.
This must have been where they lived. What's left of it? Once this was all enclosed by rock and metal.
The cord. I just woke up. I see the numbers, but can't make out the time. I was dreaming of... I was giving a lecture in Q Hall. Maybe it was something more shamanistic. I don't know. An audience of shadowy faces under a blank, open sky. I told them the world ended with a bang. A plague of robots. The last humans. We went out, not with a whimper, but a whisper. You know, in caves, ending like we started, huddled around a flickering glow. The heads of state, the Fortune Fives, the leaders, and lottery winners, and life cults, all of them buried in their little shelters. Some believing they'll live it out some way, somehow, or Elysium, or us here at Gaia Prime, no different. A multitude of tiny societies taking hold. Flaring, dying. Some will be beautiful, some horrific, and none of them matter. Short-term civilizations. One last gasp before the long-held breath. Before I wake up, I know the audience is gone.
Wow. Of course, don't forget, they tried everything they could think of. Even trying to populate another planet, or at least sending people out there that could do it, but no, that failed. They all blew up. It was, I don't mean to chuckle. It's just like, just everything that was possible.
Evacuation happened so fast.
Was tried.
No time to think things through. No time for goodbyes. There were lines in the medical ward. I told Tom Paik I'd be with him when he went under. But there was one last shipment of Paradisaidi zygotes I could get processed if I rushed. I'm still angry at him for forcing me to choose. Angry at myself for... Well, he died alone. And I didn't get the bloody birds of paradise saved either. All the time left in the world now to think. Gaia Prime's locks are sealed. Elysium sealed up, safe and sound. A distance of miles, but it might as well be on the other side of the galaxy. All the betas and gammas and support staff living their lives. If I hadn't been an alpha, if things had gone differently, I could have been there. Instead, I'm spending the rest of my unnatural life in here with people I...
Elizabeth's room. I know it. She didn't even get a chance to unpack. These are her journals. Elizabeth's journals. And they're all destroyed?
Scan them. The focus can rebuild them, but the process is slow.
Okay. File damage under repair. Okay, under repair.
To us it seems a powerful device, but its engine is tiny and limited.
How slow?
Days, weeks, years. Concern yourself with stopping Hades and extending the future, and you might live long enough to hear them.
Elizabeth journals. I will be able to hear them. I know this will happen. I just have to bide my time and press on. My focus will be working on decoding them. And I guess I'm not going to find out exactly what they mean for now.
Elizabeth, what is this?
Yes, what is this?
This is Charles Ronson. I'm logging this 6 hours after final deployment of Gaia Prime. This morning, an access port seal malfunctioned. Gaia Prime's port seals were designed to close with a seam of less than 2 millimeters. But this one closed with a 10 millimeter gap. Enough for an energy signature to bleed through. Enough for the swarm to detect this facility. Enough for Gaia to be discovered and destroyed. Enough to end the future we worked so hard to make possible. Unless the hatch servos were manually re-engaged from the outside. I'm now switching to a recording of the event.
Well, I'm not going out there. Not what I signed up for.
Either we send someone out, or all of this was for nothing.
It should be Liz's decision.
So when is she going to get here?
She said 5 minutes. You don't think...
Oh, no. Okay, everyone. I've repaired the seal. Gaia?
Seal closure at 1.4 millimeters. Confirmed.
Elizabeth, no. We'll find a way to bring you back in.
It's not gonna happen. The swarm's too close. Really. It's all right. Gaia's complete. She'll take care of things from here on out. That's what she does.
Not like this. There's so much we...
Guys, you know me. I'm no good at endings. At letting things end. So, let's not.
So... happy trails, Liz. And, see you around.
Yeah. Take care of each other, all right?
Liz.
I'm okay with this. I want to go home. Goodbye.
Was the last transmission of Elizabeth Sobeck. She gave everything for the hope of life on this planet. And we are all in her debt.
Wow. Oh God, can you believe it? Okay, I'm gonna scan these data. Oh, did you see what she was wearing though? That armor? I think you recognize it now.
You'd hate it, Liz, but I wrote you a eulogy. I had to try to express all your children. After all Apollo has taught them, they'll think they know everything. But they have to understand what you did for them. How you loved the whole world so much. With an intensity that was... dazzling.
Hell, Liz. I know. I know you're never gonna hear this. That's not the point. You got to play the savior and the Motorola once this time. Great work.
This is basically a memorial to the flowers underneath her name, her face. Right, Sylens, can you dish me up a few more layers of your arrogant sarcasm once more?
Aloy?
She's gone. Really gone.
You knew she couldn't have survived, Aloy. And her achievements were... beyond exceptional.
While her people bickered, she was the one who took responsibility. The only one who could.
She was better than them.
That's not what I said.
She was. He shouldn't be afraid to admit it.
Not in the way you mean, my friend.
You think she was better because she was smart. Because she designed Zero Dawn, but you missed the point. What made her great was that she was willing to sacrifice herself for others, for everyone who would come later.
No. She couldn't let her creation fail. You're confusing will for sentimentality.
You're wrong.
Oh my god, he's a special kind of ass, isn't he?
To think. She taught Gaia to feel. To care, to sacrifice, to believe in life, enough to fight against hopelessness. If it wasn't for that sentimentality, life would have ended. You and I would never have existed.
Your argument is sound. I'm sorry for your loss.
She said she wanted to go home. Maybe.
What?
Nothing. It's time to go on.
Oh. No. That couldn't be possible. I have to find the master override. There is still work to be done.
Hello, Margot. How are you holding up?
Dr. Ronson, I've been getting a lot of messages, unsolicited messages from Ted.
Margot, I'm sorry. With Liz gone, we've got no one to run interference with him. I'll talk to Ted. He mostly wants updates, constant updates, hundreds of updates on things he knows nothing about. Liz used to field all of his crap.
He doesn't understand the systems at all. That was kind of by design. But he's getting pretty sketchy with me.
We just have to keep him happy. Liz always said, keep him happy.
Are you kidding? You ever hear how she talked to him?
She was managing him, Margot.
I mean, maybe I should ignore him. He's buried in this pyramid with the Hola Hola girls and Panta Antimon cuckoos. What can he do?
What are we gonna plug into their heads, Liz? A whole lot of history? A whole lot of so-called truth? A whole lot of noise? It's not pablum, Liz. It's poison.
Whoa, hold on a second. Poison? Our history is lies? Hang on a minute. What are we saying here?
There's another section at the back of the crater. Looks like it survived the blast.
Because it was armored, you found the control room.
I'm on my way.
How? Okay, this way. Okay, I've just felt a rumble. Seems to be some instability. Either that or my controller's running out of battery. Oh, wait, one second.
I've been taking a hard look at the project. In the end, it's simple. It's clean. It's clear. Erasure. Addition by subtraction. I can make a better list. With a single stroke, make it all go away.
I really don't like the direction this is going.
Continue.
I can make it better, Liz, he said. I mean, the whole point of Hades was to destroy so that Gaia could rebuild. I'm assuming something else was done. Maybe Liz, Elizabeth. Effectively, our mother was not aware of. I've got to jump over that. I don't like this. Oh wow, okay. It worked. Wow, that door has not been opened for a very long time. Oh, are these the... Oh, no. This is them.
What? When I opened the hatch, the air rushed in from this side.
Because there was none inside the chamber.
But the Alphas were in there.
What did they... Did they kill themselves? Was that all they had left?
I'm locked out of core control. Alpha clearance overridden. What the hell is Omega clearance?
Oh no.
Alpha personnel. Sorry to alarm you, but I need you to listen, okay? To what I'm about to say. This isn't easy. See, please. Stop trying to access the system, okay? See, what this is about is, I said stop trying to access the goddamn system. What I'm trying to say is I can't stop thinking about the ones who'll come after us. Those innocents. Those blameless men and women. We're gonna give them knowledge? Like it's a gift?
Ted. We've talked about this before. Apollo has 3,000 plus failsafe conditions.
It's not a gift, it's a disease. They're the cure, and we're gonna give them the disease. Our disease? No, we can't. And it's not too late. If we're willing to sacrifice.
Ted, it doesn't need to be like this.
It already is, Samina. I did it 3 minutes ago. I've purged Apollo. It's gone, all of it, every copy.
What?
It's not a sacrifice, it's cultural obliteration, you crazy bastard. Millennia of culture.
I'm sorry. Really, I am. But sometimes, to protect innocence, innocents have to die.
Emergency alert. Planting atmosphere.
No! He killed them all! Faro, you wanker! Oh my god.
He killed them all.
So this is why. This is why we were trapped in benighted ignorance for an innocent future. Blameless men. He never saw the slaughter in the Sun Ring. Everything these people achieved, all the knowledge of the old ones, evaporated, turned to dust, scattered to the void, like the Alphas themselves.
No. Not a void. When the hatch unsealed and scattered their ashes on the wind, it took them out among the world they made. The world we're living in. It's a monument to what they died trying to accomplish.
A monument to oblivion.
Not oblivion, Sylens. Hope.
Yeah, a little bit more positive thinking from you, Sylens, would really go down well right now. Well, we've found the Master Override. The Alphas, oh my god. Everything they fought for. Ted Faro. Oh my god. I mean, I don't know this. Maybe part of him was right. I understand where he was coming from. Knowledge that we had created our own destruction. Maybe we shouldn't pass that knowledge on to the next generation. It's a powerful argument. But morally so. So wrong.
The Master Override. That's so small.
Now all you have to do is kill Hades with it.
Now all I've got to do is get back to Sylens' workshop.
Sound good?
Try not to fall to your death.
Brilliant.
The Master Override doesn't override gravity.
Keep holding.
Master Override doesn't override gravity. This guy, honestly, would you please drop the sarcasm? Is he on my side at all? He's just a complete knob. Okay, alright. Up, up, up. This is it. This is it. We got it. That was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. Oh, he's actually here.
For a moment.
What?
Our journey together has come to an end, Aloy. But before I go, I think I owe it to you to tell you the rest of the story.
What?
Some time ago, I admitted that I'd been involved with the eclipse. But I never told you the full extent of my culpability. The truth is, I was there at the beginning. I found Hades, Aloy, buried on that mountain, trapped in that shattered Titan. And I served it.
What?
It promised knowledge and delivered. Such knowledge, you have no idea.
And in exchange?
I helped create the Eclipse. Helped it build a cult, an army to do its will.
Why are you telling me this now?
Because your success depends on knowing this. When I found Hades, the first thing it wanted to know about was the Spire. Not Meridian. The Spire. Now, why would that be?
The Spire was created by Gaia.
Which part of Gaia?
Minerva. It's code-breaking module. Gaia built spires to transmit the codes that deactivated the Faro robots, shut down their biomatter conversion systems. Hades wants to send a new transmission. To wake the machines, so they can devour the world all over again.
Yes. Based on what we've learned, that's my conclusion as well.
So the Eclipse, the robots they've resurrected, they're just a means to an end. An army to capture the Spire.
Yes. So Hades can exterminate life all over again. Unless you stop it.
It never really succeeded, did it? That's probably why it's fixated on this. Tell me everything about you and Hades. This asshole has been lying to me this whole time.
I want you to tell me everything. Hades, the Eclipse, everything.
It's a long story, Aloy.
I will sit down then.
It began with a focus, recovered from an ancient ruin, as yours was so many years ago. In my case, the device was heavily damaged. There was just a flicker of life in it. I spent weeks studying it, attempting repairs, until finally, I succeeded. A whole new dimension of perception revealed. Right before my eyes. That's when I detected it. A faint signal. Out there, something was searching, just like I was.
A real kindred spirit.
I followed the signal to its source. A shattered Titan, buried in the jungles of the jewel.
This was Hades, this Titan, as you call it.
So you thought it was a Titan? An old war machine?
I didn't know what to think. I'd seen such wreckage before. The Grave Horde, for example. But this was different. This was not quite dead. It couldn't speak when I found it. Until my repairs gave it a voice. So began an exchange of knowledge. It wanted to know everything about our world. Its tribes and machines.
Oh, God.
But the Spire was always its foremost concern.
What did it want to know about the Spire?
Its precise location. The surrounding geography. Who controlled the land. Meanwhile, Hades revealed to me many of the intricacies of ancient technology. It bid me to recover and repair more focuses. Before long, I had a couple dozen up and running.
Enough to equip a small army.
The commanders have won anyway. I didn't care. I was learning so much. Physics, calculus. You have no idea.
So hang on a minute. Let's just pause for a second. In the middle of this conversation, he has just told me that this is the end of our journey together. Yet, in very much a skeptic and a follower of many movies and films and stories and books, telling me everything feels like he's building up to a moment where he may well take me out. I'll keep asking questions, but I have a very strong suspicion. When he says this is our last conversation, it's because he wants to end my half of it.
And the Shadow Carja? How did they become involved?
The Carja Civil War was a happy coincidence. A perfect opportunity.
An opportunity? That's what it was to you?
Yes. Overnight, half the tribe was in exile, desperate to win back Holy Meridian. Their religion made them easy to manipulate. All I had to do was present Hades as the buried shadow of their mythology. So yes, it was an opportunity. I arranged for High Priest Bahavas to meet with Hades. Helas was there as well. And so the eclipse was born. Anything to win back Holy Meridian.
Jeez.
But Hades didn't care about Meridian. And neither did you.
We live in a world of fallen cities and vanished tribes. What were a few more?
Brilliant.
Besides, I was too busy setting up the cult's focus network to Hades' specifications. A thrilling technical challenge, especially with the alterations I included of my own design.
The ability for you to spy on them.
Yes. I may have been foolish enough to serve Hades, but I was never so foolish that I trusted it. I installed what the ancients used to call a back door in the network. Secret access, empowering me to monitor all activity and communications.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I do not believe for a moment that you, one man, were capable of fooling a technology created by an entire highly intelligent technological species that came before you. You fooled Hades. Hades the outwitted Gaia. No, I don't. I think that's rubbish. You might have thought that's what you'd done.
What made you turn on Hades? It certainly wasn't your conscience.
Actually, I was troubled the first time I saw the Eclipse raise an ancient war robot with my technology. I questioned Hades about its intentions.
A little late.
Indeed. I'd already outlived my usefulness.
Brilliant.
When I completed work on the Focus Network, Hades summoned me to receive my reward. The next moment, I heard it broadcast my kill order. I've been a fugitive ever since.
You fool.
So when did I come into this? Our path together?
When Olin stumbled on you. System threat detected. That got my attention. A kill order against a savage Nora girl? Why would Hades bother with that? But then I saw that this Nora girl was wearing a focus and bore an uncanny resemblance to a great scientist of the old world. Helas moved quickly. I thought you were dead. But then I detected your focus inside the Nora mountain. The more I observed you, the more convinced I became of your extraordinary nature and usefulness. Through you, I could finally discover the secrets of the Earth. I vowed to do everything I could to ensure your success. The rest, as they used to say, is history.
Oh, God, look at that. I think the game has just given me a choice. Is there nothing you won't do for knowledge, or you've done what you could to make up for your mistakes? The moral choice. I don't know if I'm about to pick the right one or the wrong one, but I will go with my heart. I would not be alive if it weren't for this man, and I don't believe that his efforts to save me were because he wanted me to come to harm in the long run. He did want to know more, and maybe has used me for it. Either way, I'll kick his ass.
You've done terrible things, Sylens. But you've also done what you could to undo them. I can't say you've balanced the scale, but at least you've tried.
To be clear, Aloy, I would do it all again. A few more safeguards, perhaps. But basically the same.
Really? So much for learning from mistakes.
I've done all I can. From here on out, the rest is up to you. Take my lance. Fit the master override to it, and you have a means of injection.
Then I just need to get close enough to Hades' skull to stab it in?
Exactly.
Oh, no problem.
It should be relatively straightforward then.
Where will you go?
Elsewhere. And everywhere. There's so much more to discover before the world ends.
And all this?
I leave it to you, of course. As it turned out, it was yours all along. I was merely trespassing.
That was beautiful. That was beautiful.
They're coming.
Preparations are complete.
Ah, Lucent Barbas. Behold, as I promised you.
What manner of great machine is this? I've never seen such a thing.
Stay! Stay your ground, Karcher in shadow.
Incorrect. Bow before the buried shadow.
The buried shadow? I don't understand.
Did Araman understand the Glinthawk that perched upon the alight?
What?
It speaks scripture.
Araman followed the shadow cast from the spire.
To the mesa where Holy Meridian was founded.
You will follow the shadow once more.
I am a righteous man, chosen of the sun. But in times of need, the powers of shadow can accomplish what the sun alone cannot. Will you return to us what is ours, O shadow of prophecy?
An army is required. Obey, and Meridian is yours.
Of our obedience, you can be certain.
Wow, Hades really, really knew how to push the buttons and pull the strings of the people that were left remaining on the earth. I need to do this now. This is my weapon. And I believe the only thing I can use to destroy Hades. I need to return to the Palace of the Sun in Meridian. Just a second.
I traveled far to find him. I heard your transmission. It was you, wasn't it?
Entity is not known.
I'm called Sylens. And you are. I don't think you'd have called out if it wasn't something you wanted. You called, I responded. Will you tell me your name?
Hades.
You're a creation of the ancients. A war machine.
Divine timeline.
Time? Ah. It is the 13th king of the Karja Sultan's reign.
Divine Karja.
We're getting ahead of ourselves. Were you created by the ancients? I wonder how long you waited here, buried, until I chanced upon you. How long you'd have to wait for another? You're obviously very powerful, but you're not going to get anywhere without me.
Titan Flame merely houses intellect. Define Karja.
Now that's more like it.
Titan Flame merely houses intellect. Okay, so this was the chat between Sylens and Hades. But imagine being the first person to discover such an ancient...
is complete.
Yes.
...being.
The focus network is active, built to your specifications. Check it yourself if you must. I'll wait. But I remind you of the reward you've been withholding. Quantum processing.
Data has been compiled. Volume too great for transfer.
Okay, listen to me.
No. Inconvenient for me.
Come before me. You shall receive your reward.
Oh, here we go.
Helis. Threat detected inside Eclipse.
Speak its name, O Shadow, and it will die.
You will eliminate this one. Sylens.
Sylens. Yes. A truth whispered at night is seen in the day. He was never one of us. It will be done.
Well, there we go. That lines up everything. Now we know why Helis, that absolute ass who locked us in a cage, if you remember, and sent us in the arena to fight, wanted Sylens dead. Sylens was their enemy too. Sylens is actually the only one who's kind of realised, now I take it all back, I still don't trust the guy. It's not I don't trust him. I think what it actually is I don't like the way he's been able to manipulate me into solving his mystery. It was my mystery too, but it was the way he did it, you know, the way he spoke to me about getting it done, the way he had me dealt with, that I didn't like.
God needs to know that the Eclipse are about to strike. Hope he'll listen to me.
It is a long way away from here. But this is the journey I have to take. Guys, thank you so much for watching. This story has so many layers. It is a beautiful, beautiful game. If you aren't convinced yet, just from watching any of my Let's Plays, or from maybe listening to some of the story, do take the time to take it all in. One of the best games I've ever played. Take it in, enjoy it. I will see you in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching. Please, please return and watch the next part. It's all about to kick off. Thank you so much, and good night.